Caden Curry, four-star defensive lineman from Center Grove High School in Indiana. He checks in at 6'3", 250 pounds, four-star D lineman, and is the number 88 player overall in the class of 2022 on 24/7 Sports Composite Rankings. Is the 14th rated defensive lineman and number 3 player overall in the state of Indiana. I love this dude's game. He's one of the most impactful high school football players in the country. Just led Center Grove to its second straight undefeated season and 6A state title. He finished his senior year with 65 tackles, 24 tackles for loss, and 7 sacks, while also having a little bit of fun playing some running back this year, too. The Trojans finished this year ranked in the top 10 Max Preps national rankings, and Curry's a top 100 player overall in the class of 2022 for a reason, and he's going to be a big-time addition for any college he chooses. His top 5 includes Alabama, Oregon, Indiana, Clemson, and Ohio State, and an NFL comp I got for Curry is the New Orleans Saints' Cameron Jordan.
Caden Curry. Choosing between Alabama, Clemson, Indiana, Ohio State, and Oregon. Four-star defensive lineman. You saw the highlight reel. You do not want to see this guy in the backfield if you're an offensive player wreaking havoc and a top priority for some of the nation's top college football programs. About to make his commitment live right here on CBS Sports HQ. And we take you now live to Center Grove High School, just outside Indianapolis in Greenwood, Indiana. Caden Curry joining us with his mother and father. How you doing today, man?
Doing great. How are you?
Watching your highlight reel there, doing a little bit of everything, blocking punts, even running one in as a running back. You did that several times. You take it all in, go back, think of your high school career. What was your favorite memory?
Definitely when Coach Moore gave me the ball on offense, it definitely was the best. Getting out on offense and just making an impact definitely was my favorite highlights.
Any chance you're going to be able to convince your next coach to put you in on offense at the next level?
He told me he has a package ready, so let's hope.
Oh, man. All right. Package already in there for him. That would be fantastic to see. Love seeing big men getting the ball on the offensive side of the ball. Hey, what kind of a fall has this been? I mean, your junior season, you go unbeaten, you win a championship. You can't improve on that. You just have to try to do it again, and you did. How were you able to do that?
I mean, definitely our team in the offseason, we definitely got after it, and I feel like we worked really hard for it, and we just wanted to achieve greatness twice, so I feel like we definitely did that, and we all just worked our butts off.
How do you think playing for a winning high school program like you've been playing for the last 4 years will help you prepare for college?
I mean, definitely these coaches are the best of the best out of Indiana. I feel like they definitely push us to be the best, and they definitely just get us ready for that next level.
So you were undefeated this year. You were undefeated last year. Do you remember when you last lost a game?
A state championship my sophomore year.
Had a feeling that would come right off the tip of your tongue easily. So you got revenge. You won back-to-back championships. You closed things out. And now today is the big day. What's this process been like for you? I know you were kind of trying to put the recruiting on a little bit of a back burner because you had so many important games to play and because you played so deep into the fall and winter.
I mean, definitely it's a blessing to have this, talk to all these coaches and meet all these people, but it can also get stressful. I mean, just keeping them all in the loop and then just texting them every day and keeping them on status. So, I mean, it can definitely be a great time. It's a blessing to have it, but it can also get very stressful.
You see the college visits he has taken this fall, Ohio State, Indiana, and Alabama. Caden Curry going to make his decision in just moments here on CBS Sports HQ. Don't go anywhere, Caden. We're going to come right back to you and get your commitment. Want to take a look at how this would change things for some of the best programs in the country. Alabama and Ohio State are up in the top 5, so they would remain there. Clemson would jump from 15th to 9th. Indiana, his home state of Indiana, already a good class for Indiana standards for sure. 20th overall right now, they would jump to 16. Oregon from 32nd to 19th. Let's bring in 24/7 Sports Director of Recruiting, Steve Wiltfong. Steve, good to have you in studio with us. We've got the early signing period beginning tomorrow, so the next 24, 48 hours are going to be wild here, beginning with this commitment here. How could he help each one of these programs? Because, I mean, these are some of the best blue bloods in the country.
Well, Chris, there isn't a player in the country whose motor runs hotter than Caden Curry's. Caden Curry's. You know, Curtis Perry, who's announcing with us tomorrow on HQ, those are the two guys that I think play as hard as anybody in the country on the defensive line. And he is a relentless football player. And he lives in the backfield. He's a four-year starter for one of the best high school football programs in America. 90 tackles for loss over those four years. And he's a guy that plays extremely hard. He's a guy that's running down plays on the sidelines, running down plays downfield, being very disruptive. And then, like you said, they put him in on offense for big plays when they need him there.
What did you think of what he said, that the coach, where, and we don't know where he's going yet, but the coach that where he is going has said, we already have an offensive package for you.
Oh, I think that's just some good recruiting speak right there. But, I mean, he's a young man that's capable of doing anything. Nobody works harder than him. He's got all the intangibles you're looking for. His head football coach at Center Grove, Eric Moore, has referred to him a couple times as the All-American kid. And he's going to play in the All-American Bowl. And again, it comes down to just to his motor. It's always, I haven't seen a defensive lineman play that hard other than Curtis Perry in this class. So whoever gets him is going to get someone that's going to come in with the right mentality, ready to work. He loves the weight room, and I know the strength and conditioning program was a big deal for him in his college decision as well.
So January is the All-American Bowl, and then he is going to enroll early, right?
Yep, he'll be enrolling early at the school of his choice, which I know was a tough decision for him because he's also a talented baseball player. So giving up baseball to get to school and get started early and help that next program win a championship because he's accustomed to hoisting some trophies at the end of the year.
Back-to-back football championship, 6A in Indiana, did not lose a game his junior or senior season. We are going to get the commitment from Caden Curry in 60 seconds here on CBS Sports HQ as he waits at his high school with his mom and his dad. Moment of truth coming next.
This is your living room / yoga shanti / regional office / and this is the basement / panic room. Maybe what your family needs is a vacation home / vacation home. Find yours on the Vrbo app.
Cases of anxiety in young adults are rising as experts warn of the effects on well-being caused by the pandemic.
Surprise!
It's a new Buick.
Mm-hmm. You got me a new Buick?
And there are mortgages inside.
Wow!
You got me the head-up display.
Do you love it?
This year, give the gift of technology in every Buick SUV.
We're about to break some news here on CBS Sports HQ as Indiana's Caden Curry makes his commitment live right here on CBS Sports HQ. Four-star defensive lineman picking between five schools, including Alabama, Indiana, and Ohio State. Taking a look at how this would change things for the five programs that he's considering. Alabama is already the top class in the country, so they would keep a stranglehold on that. Ohio State in the top five already. Clemson would jump from 15th into the top 10. Indiana up to 16th, and Oregon would jump 13 spots from 32nd to 19th if they get the commitment from Caden Curry. Take you back out live, Center Grove High School in Greenwood, Indiana, just outside Indianapolis. Caden there with his mother and his father getting set to make the announcement. Take your time and have fun. It's a special day for you and your family.
Sir, thank you guys. I just want to first thank God for giving me this ability and this honor to take to the next level. I want to thank my coaches at Center Grove for helping me out and just get me through this. And then just thank all the coaches through my recruiting process to help me and my family to get to know us. And next year I'll be attending the Ohio State University.
The Ohio State gets Caden Curry. He was the top remaining recruit for Ohio State in the class of 22. You kept with those colors. You had the red colors in high school. You got the red in college as well. What put Ohio State over the top for you, Cade?
I mean, just from the beginning, all their players and all the coaches have showed me love, and just talking to Coach Johnson and seeing what he can do with me, what he's done with all the other players and the history of his coaching. So I just want to see what he can do with me and take to the next level.
I thought it was interesting. You were at the Ohio State-Oregon game, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So you watched Oregon, one of your finalists, beat Ohio State firsthand. What was that experience like when you were trying to decide between the two?
I mean, honestly, it was kind of a nice feeling because you get to see them lose from the other side. I mean, not only just see them win on your visits, and you want to see everything go great. So honestly, just seeing them with that other face of losing kind of showed you how much they care about winning and how much it means to them, and just kind of just what I want to fit into.
You are now a part of perhaps the greatest rivalry in sports between Ohio State and Michigan. You saw what Aiden Hutchinson was able to do as a defensive lineman against the Buckeyes this year. What kind of message do you have for Michigan?
It won't happen again.
Short and sweet. Hey, you're going to be the All-American Bowl in January, enrolling early. What made you want to still go through with playing in the All-American Bowl, despite the fact that you're committed now and you're already enrolling early at Ohio State?
Just a blessing to get it from Coach Steve Wiltfong. He gave me that invite, so just having him give me that invite and just going to play against the best and show off my talents, honestly.
That's great, man. Congratulations. I know Indiana fans will be a little disappointed to lose you in that state, but you really thought that they could have been a fit for you as well, and they've got a good recruiting class, Oregon as well. Congratulations, young man, on a career-defining day for you as you choose Ohio State.
Definitely. Thank you.
Caden Curry, four-star defensive lineman, committed to the Ohio State University, 6'3", 250-pound defensive lineman. As our Steve Wiltfong said, he's got the biggest motor out there among our commits this early signing day period, which begins tomorrow. Let's get Steve back in here. How important was this for Ohio State? I know that was the main target remaining in their class of 22.
Well, this is a guy that Ohio State's been invested in recruiting in since May of 2020. They were one of the first schools to offer Caden Curry a scholarship, and they were one of the schools that recruited him the hardest from start to finish, and I think it paid off for him here, that relationship he had with him. And he is a tone-setting type player. The way he plays the game, he's got one of the he plays the game as hard as anybody in the country. It's relentless for four quarters. He never gets tired, Chris. He's a guy that lives in the backfield, 83 tackles for loss in his career, a four-year starter for one of America's top high school football programs. He brings a pass rush presence from any spot on the field. And he's a guy that I think Ohio State's going to be able to move around in their front seven and create some mismatches with him. But he's strong, plays with great leverage, has a nose for the football, and he just chases after it till the whistle.
And reading some of the articles that you and your team put together, it sounds like he had a lot of good conversations with some of the younger players on that Ohio State team.
Yeah, I think that he really connected with those players and felt extremely comfortable. He took three visits to Ohio State, once in the summer and then returned twice for games. I think the night game against Penn State really sealed the deal coming out of that visit. He said he wanted to compare that visit to Alabama the next week. But I think really the offer from Ohio State stood out to him, stood out to him from the beginning, and getting a chance to really get to know Larry Johnson and his track record of producing defensive linemen, I think really spoke to him. And on his first visit, his time spent with Mickey Rorati in that strength program was one of the things that he gushed about coming out of that visit. So I think the time Ohio State spent recruiting Caden Curry, and then really just everything the program offers, is what separated them from the other suitors.
The high school program that he played for, one of the best in the country, just outside Indianapolis, he started as a freshman there. So, I mean, this is a kid that can play up to competition. So he can be able to step right in at Ohio State next year, you think?
Well, he's a kid that as a sophomore had 100 tackles, and then as he said, made it to the state championship game as a sophomore. But it's hard for any defensive lineman to have 100 tackles. They didn't need him to have 100 tackles as a junior and a senior to win a state championship. But whatever they needed, he was certainly there to deliver. And that was on offense this past year, where I think he had like 7 touchdowns, 5 rushing, 2 receiving. So he's a guy that can do it all. But again, the thing that really stands out with Caden Curry is the passion that he plays the game with, his motor. His head coach, Eric Moore, calls him the All-American kid. And, and the way he plays football, it's just fun to watch.
And he'll be playing in the All-American Bowl in January as well. Let's just look ahead to tomorrow real quick. I know we've got a lot to do between now and then to get there, you and your team. But what can we expect tomorrow on